Assalamu alaikum, children. In the previous class, you have learned about the plants, right? So this all plants I have told you. So it requires water, sunlight, carbon dioxide, oxygen, and many more things as we have seen in the previous class. What is photosynthesis, right? So let's come down to response to stimuli. What is stimuli? It's nothing but when we touch something hot, we'll get a feel that. We just immediately take out our hands, right? So it is called as stimuli, taking a reaction out of it. So it is something that causes a reaction. Plants and animals respond to stimuli in different way. Animals have sense organs, so they respond to stimuli at once. If they hear a loud noise, they are started and may run. If they see flash of lighting, they may just take next page. Page number 149. May close their eyes. Have you noticed that the flocks of pigeon roosting on the building fly into high air when they hear a loud noise, right? So the way of responding to the stimuli is different for both animals and plants. Next, plants have sense organs such as eyes, nose, ears, right? So they do respond to the stimuli. Next come reproduction. It is a process by which living thing produces young ones of their own kind, right? So kangaroo with the joy, hence hatching the eggs, right? So animals, mammals such as lion, tiger, rabbit, dogs, and human being are also called as mammal, which can reproduce by giving birth to young ones of their own kind, right? So they are called viviparous animal. So the 6 foot tall kangaroo is a strange creature. It gives birth to young ones, which is about the size of finger, right? So the baby, known as Joy, finds its way in his mother's pouch to grow there for many months. So the kangaroo puts his baby in his pouch and grow it for many months by feeding him. Next come plants. Mostly we have learning about plants only, right? So most plants reproduce through seeds. They seeds germinate in the soil and grow into young plants. Some plants can also reproduce by their own way, for example through cutting from the stone, like sugar plant, rose plant, sugar cane, through buds that they appears on the edge of leaves, through runners, right? So from the underground stem of the mother plant, from the roots of the mother plant, right? So we'll go for the next page. Here, have you seen what is mean by grafting? Can you tell me what is mean by grafting? Grafting is nothing but a cutting of a stem and putting in a soil which grow by its own. It is known as grafting. It does not require any seed to produce the plant, right? So grafting is a stem is cut and attached to the stem of another plant. It is nothing but if we cut a plant of a stem, if we cut a stem of a plant and attach to another plant stem, it grows in that way of plant, right? So the new plant that grow will have the characteristic of both the old plant, both as the new plant, the attached plant and the stem cutted plant, right? So it have both characters. Next, go with growth and death. Animals stop growing once they reach their full size. After the ages of time, mostly all the living things die, right? As well as animal, as well as human being, as well as plants. It comes to the limitation period. So after that, it becomes dry. Mostly the animals grow by the time they are 20 years old as so. But trees continue to grow at their leaves. Okay, so next. See you, elephant and mystic pine, right? So let's see this animation first.
You have learnt in earlier classes that there are thousands of species of both animals and plants. Animals and plants are living things. As living things, they have certain common features. At the same time, they also differ in some ways. Let us learn about the common features and differences between them. Respiration is the